because once we're done with the stones, we can return each one to its own timeline at the moment it was taken. So, chronologically, in that reality, it never left.
Yes, but you're leaving out the most important part.
Welcome everybody back to the Spinner Rack. I'm here with my boy Cal. Cal, what's rocking?
Ready to rock.
Today we have a viewer question. Yeah, and we tried this. One of our subscribers, viewers, they asked something that they wanted us to explain a little bit more in depth. And this deals with the Marvel MCU timeline after Endgame. What the goony goo happened? Does it make sense? And I gotta say, me and Cal have been butting heads on this, and we decided to put this on camera. Have you guys make a decision on what you guys think happened. So let me just lay out the basic premise. Basic premise number one, the snap occurred. Do we agree with this?
Yes.
Basic premise number two, the heroes went back in time to try to change things. Agree with that?
The heroes went back in time and did change things. Yes.
Basic premise number three, the Ancient One set out the rules to what it meant, what happens with the timelines. Mm-hmm. Do we agree with this?
We agree.
That there's one main timeline and anything else branches off.
Yes. As she described it, time is like a river, and the moment that you start doing these things, you start creating these tributaries, and those are their own entities altogether.
Okay. And we'll go into that a little bit more in depth. But I'm going to throw a bomb into this whole thing a little later, but let's just get this going. So here's the premise. This is what we're talking about. My thoughts are, and Cal, not in his infinite wisdom, does not back me on this, is that I'm saying that the timeline makes no sense. There are too many holes.
That is not the conversation we had, but okay. If that's where you want to go with it, fine. The timeline is fine, okay? There's only one outstanding hole, okay, or problem, if anything, and that is with Captain America. Other than that, the timeline is fine. It was explained and explained succinctly in the film. The problem is you basement-dwelling fanboys, okay, who live in a fictional world, refuse to accept the answer that the fictional world gave you.
So here, I'm going to blow that whole answer out the box.
Yeah, go ahead.
Because
go ahead.
We got two answers about the whole Cap situation. And the basic setup of this is that Cap goes back in time. He was only supposed to return the gem, but the stone. But what happens is he decides to stay with his girlfriend and future wife, Peggy, right?
Right.
Because he's still in love. He wants to go back. So there are two versions of this. There's two things. If you look at the what the screenwriter said, mm-hmm, and what the director says. So the directors come out and say what? They say that Cap goes into an alternate Earth. So basically, using the Ancient One's timeline, it's a tributary that just breaks off, right? Mm-hmm. That's what the directors say, the two Russo brothers, you know? But the screenwriter turns around and says, no, this is still the main timeline. So basically, using again the Ancient One formula. And listen, when we talk about time, there's only a couple of things that can happen. We have the butterfly effect. You go back in time, whatever you do affects whatever happens in the past. We've seen that in Back to the Future and other movies, okay? The other option is you have the multiple Earths option, where there's different, the quantum physics, where there are different Earths for everything. So anytime you do something, another Earth pops up, basically with that. So if you have a big toe in one Earth and you stub your toe in this one Earth and the other Earth, your big toe Earth moves on forward or whatever. Though some people say there has to be something bigger. I'm not even gonna go into that, but there's millions and millions of Earths. And then now we have this Ancient One there's one main trunk of history and everything has to stick to it, and it dies off with the tributary, which kind of doesn't make a lot of sense, but hey, we're rocking with it. But getting back to this, the screenwriters are basically saying, no, Cap is in the main thing. So there's a problem here with this whole thing, all right, if Cap is in the main timeline. One, he knows that what's going to happen with Hydra and does nothing about it. And let's not forget, Peggy was a high-ranking member of S.H.I.E.L.D. Two, his boy Winter Soldier is tortured for years upon years. This is the same thing. This Cap is a bum. Three, during the funeral of Peggy, was he there? He had to be there if he's supposedly her husband. Four, he has a super soldier serum. The man looks like he's 150 years old. You're supposed to age slowly. He shouldn't look like that. Look at Bucky. This Bucky, he got some of that derivative formula, which is supposed to be less effective than his, and he looks spry after 75 years. But our boy Captain America looks as though he's been through hell and back. Supposedly he retired. Now, I'm not saying I know what happened. They can always come back and change, say Cap was doing something, went to different time. Who knows? But I'm just saying, based on the evidence here, they lied to us.
Oh, good grief.
They lied. And you know what? Your arguments are dead. If you can explain that, my friend.
Well, see, this is a totally different argument than what we had before. I already knew you tried to do the okie doke, and you know, the whole bait and switch. Okay? Bottom line is, we don't know. The only thing, and this is what we did discuss before, there are no alternate timelines that were created based on the film. So long as the time stone, and the time stone had to be the last stone that was returned. Mm-hmm. Okay? That had to be the last stone, because without the time stone, you couldn't travel to any of the other places. Time stone allows you to go through time and space. So every other stone was returned. That means anything else that was happening with those, not going to happen. So the only alternate anything that you could have had would have been where the time stone was taken from. Now, Cap has to return the time stone to the Ancient One, okay, at the same time that it was taken. How's that possible? Hey, all he has to do is just live out. He doesn't have to jumpstart himself there. He could just literally go back, chill with Peggy, and then just live out whatever time is necessary until that incident happens. And then he's able to return it there. Now, the problem, and I acknowledge this problem, is, okay, between there and there, all this stuff happens. Now.
So you agree that you're calling Cap a masochist
and
a backstabbing friend.
Again,
that's what you're saying, right?
If you're one of these basement dwellers over here, and they need to get some sun. So the whole idea, yeah, Cap did this. You don't know what Cap did, okay? And we don't know how much influence it did. However, this much we do know, and we know this from these films that you quoted, like The Butterfly Effect. Once you start tinkering around with time, okay, once you start tinkering around with time, and to that extent, you start creating whole new futures, whole new things. Now, Cap obviously didn't do tinkering or a lot of tinkering, because at the end of the day, when we saw the end of the film with Endgame, everything was pretty much the same as it was. Now, a bigger issue was like the blip in the Spider-Man film. Oh, no, that's just totally out of there. But
we're going to get to that.
Okay, but we know that Cap returned all of the stones to where they were supposed to be. We know, okay, that he also returned the stone, the time stone, to where it was supposed to be. And we see him as an old man there, so he has been living all of this particular time.
But you haven't answered the questions. Let's start with number one.
No, I'm not going to answer. I'm not going to answer.
Because you know why? Because there is no answer to that madness.
I'm not going
to
answer your questions that are I'm not going to answer your questions that are insulting Captain America, calling him all of these things, and we don't know what happened in the timeline. We only know that he did return the stones to where they were supposed to be.
So basically, you don't want to answer the question. It's a simple question.
You can't answer it. How can you answer it?
There are two or three possible.
You're casting aspersions, okay, based on your
I'm just saying.
And this is supposed to be a discussion of intellect, not of how we feel. If you have a discussion of how we feel, okay, that could be you getting up in the morning, okay, feeling feeling terrible.
He's off the
You go use a toilet, and now you feel better. Now you feel like talking.
Who's talking about that? All I'm saying is that I set up the whole premise. If we use the butterfly effect, mm-hmm. and they're saying it's in the same timeline, we're not talking about alternate. We do have the alternate where everything that changes in alternate. We're saying in the same timeline, Cap allowed his best friend to be tortured, his wife to be attacked by people, allowed Shield to go down.
You're presuming that Cap could have stopped these things going back.
He's Captain. We didn't say he lost his powers. He's still Captain America.
How would he
had the super soldier thing.
How would he have stopped? How would he have stopped what happened with Bucky if he does not change what goes on? Now,
if he has the knowledge, hold on.
No, wait.
If you have the knowledge, something's going to happen.
Bucky is supposed to fall off that train. Yes.
Right.
Okay. That's what's supposed to happen.
And he can go back and stop it.
Okay. Now, if he stops it, if he stops it, who's to say that something else doesn't happen to Bucky and it still happens? Some things, as we learn, for those of us who are Whovians, there are fixed points in time that it doesn't matter what you do or what you like, it cannot be changed. Okay, we go look at things like Assassination of Abraham Lincoln. And we've done this story plenty of times in, you know, throughout fiction. It doesn't matter what you do. You can stop it here. It's going to keep happening. It builds up. It builds up. This is going to happen. How do we know that Cap didn't try several dozen times to save Bucky?
A whole other concept of time. What you're trying to say, the time is inflexible. You know what I'm trying to say?
No.
But you know
there
what?
There are time, but we have... There are things that we have in time. We have fixed points. There are certain things in time that are immutable. They cannot be changed. So for all we know, Cap might have tried 100, 200, a million times to save Buck, and it didn't matter. The outcome was always going to be the same. So you little basement-dwelling bastard who are talking about Cap, like, oh, look, you didn't come over here and help your friend. What do you know? How do you know he didn't try to save him 100 times? You will be silent!
I will.
How do you know he didn't come over here and try to save him? What do you know, you Cheeto-eating nerd? Okay, read a book.
All right. You actually may have a little bit of a valid point. And when I say little, I'm saying like it's so microscopic like this because I know what you're bringing up right now.
A microorganism is also known as a virus, and a virus will bring you down.
I'm talking about an electron, something inside of an electron. But like what I'm talking about, though, the reason you may have a point is because I know he saw the picture, and we all saw it, with Loki sitting down, and he has the time variant authority. You know, so using your logic, if the time variant authority is then going back in time and ensuring that certain things happen to make sure the timeline stays true to Earth, then what you just said is logically, or within the MCU, logically possible. And the time variant authority is a group that stands...
You're talking about something that hasn't even come to pass.
But it says, if you saw the Loki, I'm trying to tell you, if you see the Loki...
No, hold on, you can't go that far yet. We can only base things on what have occurred and the information that we're dealing with.
But that's
you are going into this fanboy speculation. It's like you guys need a date or something. When's the last time you guys kissed a girl? Have you kissed a girl?
Oh my gosh.
That might actually free you up from this right over here.
Kissing girls ain't a problem.
This is how we were taught criticism when I went to school. I don't know about you public school guys, okay?
We went to the same public school. What are you talking about?
No, we didn't. Okay?
Yes, we did.
No, we didn't.
Yes, we did.
I was always in the accelerated classes.
We went in the same accelerated class.
I don't know
what to say
about this guy. This guy was too busy blowing the trumpet, okay? And then when it came time to part ways over there, I went to one of the best specialized schools. I don't know what happened over here. So the way that we were taught, okay, in the specialized school... Okay, was that when it's time for you to do criticism or analysis, you can only analyze what you have there. Meaning, if I'm going to analyze this table, I can't analyze this table based on some figment of my imagination that I'm creating because I don't like how this analysis turns out. We can only analyze it based on what we have in terms of the film. Anything else that comes out later, sure, we can add that, but that hasn't come out. We have nothing definitive with that, so we can only base it on the film. And again, the stones are replaced. The only thing, okay, and the only thing, this I will give, this is the only glaring thing is, okay, what is Captain America's life when he goes back? Okay, have we just seen Captain America return the stone? Okay, and the next thing we know, he's just a regular dude and everything of that nature, fine. But that in itself presents a problem. That in itself presents a problem because remember, he takes Thor's hammer,
right?
Okay, and people are like, oh, he took Thor's hammer. Why? Because even that has to be returned. That has to be returned to where it was taken from, or else Thor in the Dark World won't have his hammer. Okay,
right.
So now we get over to the point of like, okay, let's say Cap does return the Time Stone, okay, to where he's supposed to return it to at that point. How? Okay, how now does he make certain that everything else is, you know, effectuated because he was supposed to be in a different time when all of that happened? So, of course, he's got to live that time out to get to that particular portion. Good?
Or he could have used the time stone to go back and forth and do different things. All right, so look, you're trying to disagree with me, the time variant authority. Another point I want to make is, and the reason I brought it up is because Loki in the commercial is clearly visible, the TVA, and you see who he's talking to. Now, let's get back to the movie once again. Loki disappears. According to the producers and that, he goes into another timeline.
Yes.
So because now he's no longer, it makes perfect sense that Loki, we're trying to bring Loki back into the timeline. The same thing goes with Nebula. Nebula goes into the time, goes to the past, 2014, to try and...
And ends up killing herself.
And gets killed. by the other version.
But they worked that whole thing out. I don't agree with how they worked it out, but they worked it out saying, okay, so fine, killing yourself over here has no consequence on you being alive.
But then, wait, you know what, come and think about it.
It doesn't make a lot of sense
to me. But didn't the Ancient One say if you die here, you die there too or something
like that? No, I don't remember the Ancient One saying that.
Well, I thought it was some type of thing, like if you die someplace.
Well, that's been the standard. That's been the standard for time travel for, you know, a very long time. If you kill your past self, then you don't get to live out to your future self.
But if he went to 2014 and killed yourself, then the 2014 self then comes to the future. Then technically,
you're making this too difficult for yourself.
I'm just saying that the 2014.
If you kill your past self, your future self never happens. If you kill yourself, that's the same thing.
Right,
if Nebula goes back and kills herself as a baby, okay, she's never supposed to exist.
But I'm saying Nebula was a future self, so if she kills her future self, she's still okay.
If your future self goes back and kills yourself as a baby, you're not supposed to exist.
No, we're talking the same. If you
it's the same principle. It's the same principle. It's no different.
So the point is there. Look, so we have Nebula. Then we also have the whole thing with Gamora. Well, Gamora comes back. You know what I'm trying to say? A new Gamora. Gamora died.
That's finger snap. That has nothing to do with the stones. That has nothing to do with the returning of the stones. Everybody who died comes back.
No, she didn't come back. She came through with Nebula and Thanos.
Okay, okay. Correct, that's what I'm trying to say.
So it's totally different there. You know, so this is a whole new Nebula. I mean, whole new Gamora who doesn't know anything
about... No, it's not a whole new Gamora. This is a past Gamora who never got to go through those experiences. Not a whole new person.
All right, but I'm saying those experiences made her who she becomes.
And that has nothing to do. That has nothing to do with where we are in terms of this discussion, which was supposed to be about the stones. You've done a nice job of trying to digress from the whole thing.
I answered our viewers' question about the Captain America, just like the Ancient One said,
we're going to bring the stone right back, and we're going to keep on this particular tributary. The only issue that I had, okay, is that we don't know what exactly happened with Captain America, other than the fact that he decides to live in the past.
And that's so convenient.
That's it.
Because then you don't have to answer anything. The point is that we see the effects that happen after.
No, I don't have to answer anything, don't have to speculate on what happened either.
But there's no speculation. Think about it.
You're 100% speculation. There is nothing you have said that you can affirm. Nothing.
Of course. If the timeline, there's two options. If it's an alternate timeline, then I can agree with you. We don't know what the hell happened.
There are no alternate timelines. Think of it this way. Loki, okay, they're saying that Loki goes and he's supposed to be TVA and everything of that nature.
Another alternate timeline.
That should never happen. Why? Because Cap went back and replaced the stone before any of that nonsense happened. So all of the events that would have happened for Loki to disappear don't happen. Now, that's in story. Out of story, okay, let's just take a pause for a moment. Out of story, Loki's a very popular character. He was killed off in Infinity War. We need to find a way to bring him back into it. Oh, this is how we bring him back into it, so we can do those sort of things, so we can still have Loki as a character, and we can still work with this guy, and we've had a lot of fun with. But if we go by what was established in Endgame, Loki should still be dead. Okay, because the stone was replaced, that means he never escaped. None of that stuff happened.
But according to the story, he does escape and that stuff. So look, I'm not going to belabor that point because we're clearly wrong once again. But
clearly wrong. I just established an error in the whole. I just established an error. Okay, in what these guys are talking about, you should be saying good, good, good. Okay, so you're at least being honest and above board.
I'm trying
to come over here and cast aspersions again. Not going to happen.
I'm not casting. What I'm just saying is that it makes perfect sense that he would branch off to another alternate timeline.
Now, until the stone is returned.
But the stone was returned
before he could have ever done any of that, so it never happened. So the fact that Loki is alive is an anomaly if he's actually alive.
That's
something you can go to town with. Hey, how is this guy still alive if the stone was returned? That's something that you can definitely punch up all day long.
We want to focus on the big kahuna, which is Captain America.
Yeah, all right.
And you know what about? Here's another thing. Now let's get to the blip.
Pulling some more out of you. Let's get to the blip, baby.
Mm-hmm. So,
the blip. I'm pretty much going to agree with you on the whole thing. That makes no
sense. Okay. That
makes no sense whatsoever.
If you're going to go like this first, then I know that's agreement. That's the only way I know that's agreement. Anything else comes out
you
your mind?
You want to put some pumps on and a short skirt
like
while I do it too?
Then I know that's
you're
agreement.
Out of your mind.
Anything else
not going
to
happen.
Agreement.
Not going to happen.
All right. So, here's the problem with the blip, and the reason we're bringing this up again. One of the viewers or subscribers that asked is like, you know, look at how Crisis handled the change when the world changed over, right?
Uh-huh.
Everything, most people didn't remember what happened. All these worlds came together, got destroyed, new multiverse restarted, but no one remembers except the heroes and a select few people, right?
Uh-huh.
Everything goes on. There are changes naturally now that you have a world with different heroes and where before there were like one hero or whatever. But in the Endgame universe, the blip happens, 5 years goes by, and people just come back to where they were before. The illogicalness of that is crazy because, so you're trying to tell me, let's say 80% of the population stayed the exact same place. Didn't budge, didn't go anywhere, you know? Well, 20% came back.
These guys are trying to have, the problem was in that instance, you're trying to have your cake and eat it too. Because they wanted everybody who died to come back, but at the same point, they didn't want, this was really for Tony Stark, he's like, bring everybody back, but don't change anything that happened in those 5 years. That way I don't have to lose my daughter. The thing would have been, okay, I'm going to snap, I'm going to bring everybody back, and I'm going to revert everything to where it was before everybody left. That solves a lot of these issues at the end of the day.
All the issues.
They're like, no. We don't want to do that because we want to make certain we keep this. So now we're going to keep this, but in keeping this, we make a big mess in keeping that.
Complete mess.
You know, the whole idea is like, look, they addressed it in Spider-Man, and my hope is that they never bring it up again. You know, just go forward. Nobody needs to talk about it anymore. That's the best thing that you can do. Because then you just get, oh, God, you just get into Uber.
Right, but I'm just
you get into Uber Nerdville talking about stuff that you can't answer.
But, you know, you're right. But I'm just saying the problem here is that I think the problem is that you put the MCU in a quagmire. They're going to have to come up with other movies and shows. And this is what I think they're talking about, where you have Doctor Strange, the Multiverse of Madness, the whole thing with the Loki being able to go to different, or possibly go to different timelines or universes or times. These are supposed to correct, I believe, some of these issues.
There's an answer. There's an answer for Captain America. I'm waiting for you to say. I'm surprised you haven't said it yet. But let's keep going. We got a few more minutes before we got to cut.
So I think the MCU is already in correction mode because they recognize the issues that are coming there. But that blip was really like just totally off. And I have a strong feeling that now that they've revealed Spider-Man, and of course it's a spoiler if you haven't seen the movie, that's ridiculous. But Spider-Man, that whole thing with him revealing his identity can't last past the next movie.
No,
they're gonna have to do something that reverses everything back.
That ended for me in a very enjoyable movie on a point where I was like, why in the world would you do this stuff?
Yeah.
Peter Parker is one of the. See, I understand where a lot of these guys don't want secret identities, like in terms of the actors,
because
they're like,
sense.
Okay, I want to see my face and that type of stuff. I just don't be running around in a mask. Got it. But even in that film, when he was walking around and he's like, oh, I'm Peter Parker. And I was like, you don't know who these people are. Don't you wear a mask for a reason? And then at the end, he's kind of like, oh, I've been exposed. I'm like, dude, you've protected your secret identity, like, you know, literally with less regard than a dog for a bone. You know, at least a dog buries a bone. Okay. You wouldn't even wear your mask half the bloody time. So, you know, the whole thing, they have to deal with that because, again, Peter Parker is one of the few superheroes. You need a secret identity because people will come out and try to hurt people at the end of the day.
I mean, hey, if I'm a supervillain, the first thing I know, the secret identity, I'm coming after your family.
Yeah.
I'm going to get you to do what I need you to do. You know what I'm trying to say? You're getting blackmailed. I'm coming after your family. We're taking over the world. You're going to be my front man.
And he's not Superman.
I'm planning this all out already now. And I don't even have the powers yet.
And he's not Superman, where it's like, okay, Clark Kent is a disguise for the most part, but Peter Parker has a real life. Peter Parker needs to be able to be Peter Parker. Spider-Man is really like the side gig at the end of the day.
But even Superman has the same problems. You know, if someone knows who he really is, Clark Kent is Superman, the first thing you're going to do is go after who? His family. You go after Clark Kent's family.
Here's the big problem with that. It depends on where you're coming into the comic. His family's dead. His parents are dead.
But let's say they're alive.
No, they're dead. So, you know, that's where you would go with that instance.
Then you go after Lois anyway
because he has a relationship with Superman as a friend. Same thing with Jimmy Olsen, same thing with the Daily Planet. The thing with Clark Kent, and they botched this up, is like in the Bronze Age, Clark Kent actually had friends of his own. There were people who knew him, Clark Kent. They didn't interact with, you know, Superman at all. Then you could have been over there like, okay, fine, we're going to go after the people that you know. Now, not so much. Everybody who's close to Superman
knows who he is.
Everybody who's close to Superman pretty much is in the know at the end of the day. And who are you going to go after? Batman? You know, you really want to take that chance?
He got nobody who's close to him.
No, I'm saying that's somebody who will be close to Superman. Batman's like, oh, wow, we know that you're Clark Kent now. You know who we're going to go hurt you? We're going to go after Batman. Oh, you know, like, huh? What? The other problem is that with Superman is that the down-the-line thing. If you can sort out, well, Superman is Clark Kent, You know, then you can start doing the research. Well, who has this Clark Kent guy been with since it's Superman and he's with these other superheroes? Let's see if we can, like, you know, collate, you know, who he's actually been with. Oh, wait a minute. There's a tall, this chick over. Yeah, that must be Wonder Woman right over there. And then you can just start knocking down the dominoes from there. But that whole thing with Spider-Man and the identity reveal is just like, no, just wrap that up as quick as you can. Do that, like, in the opening credits of the first five movie or something, where, you know, they have him, you know, Peter Parker fighting, he gets beat up or something. They're like, this guy's Spider-Man? Whatever. Been some internet hoax. And just leave it alone. Leave it alone. Don't do like Arrow. We're gonna, every season, you know, we're going to try to out this dude, and then eventually he's going to end up working for the government, which is where Spider-Man almost was at the end of that film. That being said, nice digression once more. We're back. And again, the stones are returned. Okay, the stones are returned.
The issue is not the stones being returned. The issue is the consequences of what Cap did. That's the
consequences.
Key. There's a huge consequence, bro.
If there was a consequence, we would have seen it at the end of the film. The only consequence that we see is that Cap ages like a normal person,
which is another huge consequence. He has a super soldier serum. He shouldn't be aging.
Do we know what life Cap has lived since he returned? Since he returned back to the past and decided to live that time out?
If he's leaving,
we don't. So you cannot make any analysis or judgment based on what you do not know.
I'm using what the producer, mm-hmm. what the screenwriter, and what the director. If those cool guys are not in the group or not in the know from their versions of it, then what the hell?
Okay.
They're going to get?
You sound like a loveless, dateless nerd, okay, who's going and hitting up a screenwriter and a director for information that's already in the film, okay? These guys get hit up because guys are trying to win an argument. See, look, and there you have two totally different responses. You have one person said one thing, somebody said something else. So you have to go with the film. That is your definitive information. And the film doesn't give you anything to answer that question. So you can continue to look at, hey, that's like you walking down the street. What's the meaning of life? Okay. And you don't get a satisfactory answer because no one can answer that question for you. Only you can answer that question for you. Now we have the film. The film gives you all the answers you want. You sit back. I don't like these answers. I don't want these answers. I want answers that satisfy me.
Our subscribers, you know what? You are impinging and insulting our subscribers and stuff with your answers.
No, you, nerd.
I apologize for his behavior. Can't be controlled. Where he went to school was a really rough spot, so I cannot, you know, school
nerd.
Learning. I can't help you with that. But, you know, I think that any reasonable person will see, and it's a reasonable argument, you know, that if Captain America, if it's an alternate timeline, everything he says makes sense. It's different.
There's no alternate timeline. Stones were returned.
But if it's consistent, if it's in a main timeline, the very fact that his best friend, because look, we've seen the results. What you keep forgetting is we see the results at the very end. Bucky has become Winter Soldier. So in order for him to become Winter Soldier, it means he's been tortured and treated badly. We see the results. SHIELD is destroyed.
We already addressed the Winter Soldier thing. You're trying to act like we didn't just discuss this.
Destroyed.
It's on tape. If you're watching, just rewind. Okay, go back. You know, go back to, like, I think about what? We're about 8 minutes in? Yeah, go back to right over there. He already conceded that point right
Never
there.
Conceded it.
The
Never
only thing,
conceded it.
The only, yeah, go back. He conceded
Never
it.
Never conceded
it. The only thing that I could think of, okay, that I would give some legitimacy to is what if the guy who we saw at the end of the film was not actually Steve Rogers, Captain America? Okay, that was the only thing that I went to, and that would make for some good storytelling later on, because I was like, well, everybody's making this assumption that the guy that we saw over there is actually Captain America. What if that isn't Captain America that we saw at the end of the day? What if that is some other person and Cap?
A Super Skrull?
Not necessarily a Skrull or anything, but again, not Captain America. If that isn't Captain America, okay, then, okay, we would have a whole bunch of other stuff going on.
There is nothing in that scene or in the movie to let us. Like he was just saying, we need to stay within the frame of the
There's
movie.
There's nothing that in the scene. He's an old man. And you yourself said the super soldier serum should keep him young. There's nothing in the scene.
There's nothing in the scene.
Yeah, keep on smiling.
And he is coming up with something so far-fetched. There's nobody in a reasonable mind could think about
that. That is the only thing that I could actually think of in terms of it. But again, going by the film, there's nothing to support that, with the exception of Captain America being an old man when we see him, and that would be more speculation. But I'm surprised that the speculators have not come out and said that. They have said everything else when I've read. Oh, this, that, and the other. There's a purple time stream and a green time stream. But at no point did anybody say, hey, wait a second. Why is everybody assuming that this is actually Captain America? What if that isn't Captain America? What if something happened to Steve Rogers on the way, okay? And we got this guy over here, okay? We got the shield and everything of that. We got the shield, okay? Why do we believe that that's actually the shield too? You know, maybe this is not exactly everything that it's supposed to be. Maybe they're setting us up for like a really good story a la Secret Empire, where there was a fake Captain America running around. Maybe there's that going on. But no, you people don't read the comic books. You people are in your basement. Okay, you're over in your basement trying to get out, and you can't get out because you're too busy hitting down directors and screenwriters instead of making out with girls, getting a job, and getting on with your life at the end of the day. There is no alternate timeline.
All right.
Full stop.
Once again, we're going to have the truth and fantasy going on right here. You know, thank you guys for coming back to Spinnerack and having a nice discussion. I just want to thank our subscribers for submitting that question to us directly.
Yes, thank you for that. Thank you.
Spinnerack
out.